One.
La fiebre te encendía. Oye, en lo que comienza la fiebre, yo voy a montarla en la grande 1030.
Ando en la chiquita, bien tirado. Corriendo a mis revoluciones conmigo. Acelero el evolution bien mal criado. The show, mi revolución es minuto. Ando en la chiquita, bien tirado. Corriendo a mis revoluciones conmigo. Acelero el evolution bien mal criado. The show.
Muy buenas tardes. Muy buenas tardes, querida fanaticada. Bienvenidos, bienvenidos una vez más a este tu programa de todos los sábados, Revoluciones por Minuto, cuando hoy estamos revolucionando el mundo. ¡Un aplauso! ¡Welcome! Good afternoon, everybody. Ok, buenas tardes, Paquito.
Hola, Marta, ¿qué tal? Buenas tardes a ti y a toda la audiencia de este magnífico, el mejor programa. Revoluciones por minuto.
Wow. Muchas gracias. Bueno, y continuando, ¿verdad? Tenemos aquí, me enorgullece presentar a Rafael Rodríguez.
Buenas tardes a todos.
Bienvenido al programa. Welcome, gracias. Welcome to the show. Welcome to Radio RPM de 1 a 2 de la tarde. Y señoras y señores, me complace en presentar. I'm very proud to present not only a professional guy, okay? But also my dearest friend, Roy Spiker.
Thank you very much.
Oh my God, finally I have this guy here for so many years. I'm trying to bring Roy Spiker to Radio RPM and it never happened. This time, ladies and gentlemen, I have this great man here talking, and today we got it in the hot spot, okay? And he's gonna say everything today, right, Roy?
That's right. I'm gonna reveal everything.
Oh my God! No, sin censura, sin censura. En el día de hoy, no, Roy. Thank you very much for being here. I know you have a lot of things to do, okay? But in a Saturday, thank you for giving me this, you know, this hour. And I hope everybody's gonna know who is Mr. Roy Spiker. It's been in the, around for so many years, okay?
Yeah, more years than we expect. I want to think about.
Así es, mi gente. Y en el día de hoy también les vamos a hablar de lo que está pasando en el Orlando Speed World. Como invitado especial, our friend Roy Spiker here with me in Radio RPM. Comentarios del público, entrevistas, y también Rafael nos va a estar hablando de qué vamos a hacer si nos encontramos todavía dentro de un tiroteo, ¿verdad que sí? Porque déjame decirle, esto es un tema que never end, ¿ok? What about if you are inside the shooting, ¿ok? What are you going to do? You know, we're going to talk about that, and you going to
yeah,
help me.
Yeah, I got a comment. I know what I would do.
I know you have a comment, okay? Also, vamos a hablar de la última pelea de Cotto. Cotto finalmente se retira, pero nos ofrece una última pelea. Te voy a decir cuándo. También tenemos a Danica. Danica, Patrick is gone. She's leaving. She's a great woman, but never, you know, function properly in the NASCAR field. Okay. Así es que eso y mucho más, señoras y señores, después de la pausa que vamos a estar, tenemos un show sumamente caliente en el día de hoy. No lo quites. Ya volvemos. ¡Guapera!
Oye, gracias Puerto Rico por hacer de Street Legal Wet tu favorito, el que más brilla, el que más dura y el único que no salpica. Ahora te trae la bestia azul, el degreaser que pela la grasa. Más fuerte que la bestia azul, ninguno. No perfumen la grasa, sácala con la bestia azul. Street Legal te lanza un reto, ¿sí? A ti que estás escuchando y que nos estás viendo. No uses más de lo mismo. Cambia la amarilla y la verde por la negra. Una vez que uses Street Legal multiuso, no volverá a esos multiusos viejos que son más de lo mismo. 100% hecho en Puerto Rico. Street Legal multiuso, no mancha, limpia mejor, y el que hace espuma para lavar tu carro. Búscala en tu establecimiento favorito. Atrévete a romper la rutina. Cambia a la negra de Street Legal. ¿Alguna duda?
En Powder Coating Specialty utilizan una técnica de alta calidad para cubrir hierro, aluminio,
cobre, acero inoxidable y cristal, resistente al óxido y más duradero. Para que los aros de tu auto tengan ese terminado especial y duren hasta 10 veces más que cuando son simplemente pintados, visita Powder Coating Specialty en el 839 Soldot Trail en Kissimmee, de lunes a sábado de 9 a 5. Powder Coating Specialty tiene mejor servicio, son más económicos y su trabajo está garantizado. Para precios competitivos, pregunta por Jimmy o Eric al 407-452-2423.
Al Pizza no solo tiene la más famosa y auténtica pizza estilo New York, sino que también preparan sabrosos sándwiches y calzones. También puede hacer su orden por teléfono. Llame a Rubén al 407-935-0063. Localizado en el 1107 Bryan Street, en Kissimmee, donde le darán el servicio que los han hecho famosos.
Berlin Race Club, 407-910-8226. Fabricación de autos de competencia, medio, tres cuartos y full chasis, roll bars, roll cage, cajita de wheelie bars, chapas para four links, mangas de diferencial forrado en aluminio y carbon fiber. 407-910-8226. Berlin Race Club.
Iturrino Photo Studio, sus fotógrafos profesionales para bodas, ocasiones especiales y todo tipo de actividad. Se producen portfolios de modelos y calendarios. Para precios competitivos, favor llamar al 407-694-2654. Contamos con artistas gráficos para diseñar tarjetas de presentación, flyers de actividades, promociones y mucho más. 407-694-2654. Iturrino.com.
Les habla Miguel Cotto, no se retiren, que están escuchando Revoluciones por Minuto.
Muy buenas tardes, querida fanaticada, bienvenidos. Bienvenidos una vez más a este tu programa de todos los sábados, Revoluciones por Minuto. Hoy me complace en presentar, tengo como invitado especial a Mr. Roy Spiker, here with us today. Also tengo a Rafael Rodríguez. Y por ahí tenemos pues la primera llamada del día. Adelante, estás en el aire. Hello.
Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes, Bombi, ¿cómo estás?
Buenas tardes, aquí en Baja, ya tú sabes, mejorando.
Okay, perfecto. Bombi, we have Roy Spiker here, and I know you have a lot of things to say, and I know you have a lot of questions. This is the moment.
First of all, I want to thank Roy for all the years and all the things he's done for us at the racetrack at Lakeland Drag Strip, to offer us his drag strip throughout the years, all the Spanish community in Orlando, Kissimmee, all over Florida, from all over the world. I want to thank him personally. Not only as a owner of a track, also a good friend of mine, and everything he's done for the sport. You know, I mean, now that there's no more racetrack, I mean, it's going to be hard for him, because that was one of his, you know, passions, and, you know, being in the sport. I just want to thank him and thank him for everything he's done for the sport, and, you know, it's going to be Roy forever.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it. My run with the racetrack was about 30 years, and I really enjoyed it. Some of the parties we had out there, and everybody bringing all the Latin food out there, it was just it was unusual. Yes, we set the scale for a lot of people.
All right.
We had good times, we had bad times, you know. We had, you know, a lot of things happened to us there, a lot of, you know, good things, bad things, like I said, and
I had all good.
People front, some people behind, you know. It's
had all life. All good times.
That's what he meant.
Wasn't no bad times.
Okay, Roy. Now that we have you here, how did you start Lakeland Drag Strip? And people asking, how this guy started this? He's a gringo. He's a white guy. Why?
And he doesn't even race cars. And he doesn't even get in the fast cars.
Exactly.
It was a business adventure of mine, and I just
supposed to be there.
Kind of just dripped off into it and went with it. I went to Orlando Speed World, which one of my two of my great friends are there. Yeah. Carl Weisinger, which I understand is retired now, and I don't understand. I know he's retired. I was hoping he would be here today. I'd like to say hi to him so I could check him out and see how his hair's doing and see if he's gained any weight since he retired. And give him a hug, so I know he's doing well. And then, of course, Ozzy owns the Orlando Speed World now, and I would like to say hate Ozzy. He's had my track leased for the last 5 years and did a great job. No problems with ever with Ozzy. Ozzy was a stand-up person. I couldn't have had a better person take care of my facility while I was retiring. But I had a great time. It was a wonderful time. I got to experience racing. I got to experience Latin people like I'd never experienced before. It was just a good time. I really enjoyed it.
Okay. What made you decide to make Lakeland the Puerto Rican track? Okay. Not too many people deal with Puerto Ricans. And why? How you do that?
Well, I noticed that I didn't fit in a slot anywhere because I was an eighth mile track, and of course, as you all know, that Orlando was a half mile, quarter mile track, and then of course, when you went to DeSoto, it was a quarter mile track, and I think the Latin people in the Puerto Rican community needed an eighth mile track, and nobody wanted them because of the imports made more noise, and they didn't want them, period.
Oh, gosh.
Because they made so much noise, and then we'd heard of an accident where a fan come off and went through somebody's body and all these terrible things. So I thought, there I am right there. There's my niche right there in the market. So once I started the import track, and then of course after Andrew, they had a big migration of all the Latin and import people into Orlando and Tampa and stuff. So I found my niche in the market that nobody wanted until I got it. Then they all wanted it.
That was the best decision that you make in life.
But it was mine.
And okay, Bumby, are you there?
Yeah,
go ahead. You have a question.
I also have some good news. Larry McBride, Spider-Man, a top fuel motorcycle, 567, 250 miles per hour, world record.
Wow.
Again.
Just happened at the racetrack. Also, I want to thank everybody who supported me and, send their prayers out for me, for my condition that I have. I was in the hospital. I want to thank everybody. Quiero agradecer a esa gente que han llamado y han puesto mensaje a Marta de texto por mi condición. Estoy un poquito mejor, pero tomando blood thinners, pero para adelante. Y gracias a toda esa gente que se preocuparon por mí.
Great.
Y para adelante. Gracias a todos.
Okay. Bumby, you have another question, because there was so many years that we spent Lakeland drag strip. And a lot of things happened there, but I always remember the good things, okay?
There's always good things and bad things. I remember Roy being sick and us going to his house and being with him by his bedside. Many years ago.
Yeah, that was scary stuff.
Very scary thing. He opened up his restaurant. We supported him throughout his restaurant venue that he had going over there. So many things, So many things. Great man, great family, Roy forever.
Okay. All right. Roy, why retire for everything now? Why not before? Why now?
Well, I think, Magna, as you get older, you realize you're not going to live forever, even though I'm going to. I just turned 69, so it was a good time to... the economy was coming back, and it was a good time, and everything was right to retire. And I'm really, really, really enjoying retirement. I don't know how long it'll last, but I'm there anyhow.
Retirement is forever. What are you talking about?
Not for me.
Why you say that?
Well, I think I'm going to go into the land clearing business. I met somebody with a lot of money, and he wants to be clear thousands of acres of land, and I know people that can do that, so that's what I'm going to do, I think.
Okay. Oh, wow. What is the next chapter of Mr. Roy Spiker?
Well, I think I'm going to get married again. I've been married 7 times. I think I'll get married one more time.
Oh, no.
Hey, some people never learn.
Never learn.
Do we know the victim?
No, I don't even know her, but I know I'm going to marry her.
Are you going to have the last fight like Cotto?
one more time? Yes, one more time.
Okay. This is so great, to have you here and know. But how you start in this business, Roy? I know. Where are you from, Roy?
I was raised in California, so there's where my passion comes for cars. I really like Just about anything that the Spanish people do with the cars. I really enjoy the low riders and the hydraulics and big wheels, and I love all that stuff. It's always been a passion. Cars is
okay. Well, what do you think, huh?
Great.
Luis, you have a question.
Tell them about your new ride.
Yeah.
Oh, my new ride. I've got an SLK on 32s with four-wheel drive suspension on it, and it's really a beautiful car. Wait till you see it, Bumby. You'll love it.
Wow, we we're gonna take some pictures.
That's what makes you happy. That's good, you know.
That's all it's about. If it doesn't make me happy, I'm not gonna do it.
Oh my goodness!
That's right.
Oh, they show me here. They show me some pictures right now, and this is so spectacular. Oh my God, Roy, you're amazing. Okay. Bumby, another question for Roy.
Roy's never going to retire. I know that for a fact. Roy's a busy man. He's always got to be busy doing something. I don't see him retiring anytime soon.
No, I have 23 grandkids, so I think I'm going to dedicate my last part of my life into making sure their life runs the way I want it to, with helping with their financing, their houses, and things of that nature.
Okay. All
right. That's good. That's a very important thing.
Family,
all right,
everything.
Bumby. We're going to put you on hold. We're going to take the next phone call, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Hello. Welcome to the show, Radio RPM. Hello.
Buenas tardes, Marta.
¿Sí? ¿Quién habla?
Es la doña Irene, ¿cómo estamos?
Oh, my God, doña Irene, welcome to the show. We got Roy Spiker in the house today.
I see. You got one of the legends.
Exactly.
From our time.
I never thought it that way, but it's pretty cool.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah, you're actually one of our heroes.
Well, thank you.
The letters race.
Thank you
back
very
in
much.
The days.
Yeah.
I tried.
Yeah, and
you did the best. You are the best. You gave us the opportunity. You gave us the chance to race in your track, you know. And from there we took off, you know. We showed the whole world what kind of cars we have, what type of cars we could do, we could make, and we could build, and how fast we could go.
That's right.
That track, that's our home track here in Florida. You know, no matter if they're going to make a building or whatever, it's going to be always the home track.
Exactly. And it's feel like you've been in your house with your family. That's the kind of feeling that everybody used to feel in Lakeland Drag Strip, right?
That is true. You go there, it's like a family. Like you own the track because you could, basically you do, you know, you feel homey. You look like... do whatever, you know, you feel homey, you don't have no complaints. I mean, the staff was awesome. I mean, the track was awesome too, you know. So, I mean, it was one of the best tracks we had here in Central Florida. Because I remember back in the 90s, well, you couldn't go nowhere. We started on the streets, and from the street we moved on to Lakeland. It's a big chance. It's a big thing.
Thank you very much for those kind words. I need those words in this time in my life.
Oh yeah, definitely. Like I said, you are a hero. You was our hero. You know, it still is.
Eso merece un aplauso.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I really need that.
Wow.
I need to know how well I did.
Yeah. That's
oh yes, yeah. You did. Yeah, I mean, that track. I have so many memories. Since I was a little kid, I used to race in the track. So, you know, thank you very much, you know. I appreciate a lot what you did for us.
You're welcome, and thank you very much for those kind words.
Thank you, Doña Irene.
No problem.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Going back, okay, Luis.
Yeah, I just want to do something I forgot to do many years ago.
What?
I forgot to give him the keys of the track.
It is true.
Hey, that was the blue lock.
Yeah. That is true. Oh, my God, Louis. That was so nice.
I shared my track with a lot of people.
I
give them keys to it. So
it is true. It is true.
So
that's the key of the track. You know, another question. And Roy, I know many years ago, like 8 years ago, we decide... or you decide to put Lakeland in the hands of the women. Okay. And that was me. And I feel so proud because that was like 3 or 4 years that I was running, you know, doing a lot of things on Leyland, helping you a lot. And we came out with the Pan American Racing. What do you think about that time? And what make you trust me?
Well, you know, in life, we have to go with that gut feeling and everything. And I know Magna was a great person. She was trustworthy, and her word was worth something. And as well as Lewis, which is her husband, which is a great friend of mine as well. And when it feels right, you just go with it. And if you don't feel right in the gut, you don't do it. And usually your gut will tell you what's right. And that was one of the better things I ever done in my life, was meeting Magna. Her and Lewis have remained close friends.
Thank you very much.
All my life.
Thank you very much. That made me feel so good. Okay. And I know we have a great time. We have another phone call. Welcome to the show, Radio RPM. Hello.
Hello.
Sí, welcome.
Hey, Roy, how you doing? Good afternoon to everybody.
Wow, the Messi in the house.
Yeah.
Hey, woo.
Thank you for calling
in. I hate to hear what I'm hearing, but hey, that was my home for a lot of years since I came to Florida in 92. And wow, when I came to that track, the best impression I ever took of that track was, it was always packed on Sundays and Saturdays, and I didn't have nowhere to run because I just had gotten to Florida, and I used to go over there every Thursday to burn the crap out of my car. Man, those were the good old days, and I can't see me missing that now. You know,
Demencia was
home
part.
Is shut down.
Yeah. Demencia was the guy who inspected the cars, remember?
Oh, yeah.
I never forgot. The relay runner, the troublemaker, the everything.
Right. Nah, never a troublemaker. Puerto Ricans don't start trouble. What are you talking about?
Well, trouble from the ones
they
that
just
didn't want to run properly.
Yeah, all right. No, thank you, Demencia.
As I could.
Yeah.
Hey, well, good. Roy, so what's next for you? What makes you decide to close the track?
The price was right, and I was ready to sell, and just, I'm getting old, and I'm getting tired and stuff. I'm almost 70 years old, and somebody come along and offered me too much money for it, so I said, okay, turn the
page. Hey, quit lying about your age. You know you're 50.
I just made it to 50. I'll be 70 my next birthday, I'm proud to say, and I'm in ungodly good shape, so I want to enjoy the rest of years of my life with my grandkids and things.
Oh, that's nice. That's a good reason also. You know.
So they're going to have a new development in there and stuff?
Yeah, I understand that they're going to build a building bigger than the one next door to it.
Oh, my God.
And it is a big building next door.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. I had a suspicion that the auction people that were across the way would have bought that part.
Well,
bigger auctions. I travel through there almost every other day, every other week through Tampa, and I would stop by through.
I was surprised that they didn't buy it. They just never stepped up to the pump, and there was just nobody that wanted to buy a racetrack. So it is what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. It hurts, but it's true. But
time to move on.
Thank you for all the years that you have gave to the sport. I mean, you know, we love you.
Well, thank you. Thank you for being a good friend.
That took us in and where nobody wanted us. But you showed everybody that we were competitive, and look at the level we have gotten now. Now they're scared of us.
You guys are setting the pace. The Puerto Rican people are setting the pace for the rest of the world.
That's true.
Exactly. So now they know we're coming, and we're coming strong.
Knowing that.
And thanks to you that you were the one who gave us the opportunity. And let me tell you, God bless you, and may God give you everything you want for whatever you want to live. And I know you can make 100 if you feel like it. So
I am shooting for 100. I have not give up on that number.
Woohoo!
100 is the lucky number.
That's my number. After that, I don't care if I fall overboard and the sharks eat me. I want to make it to 100.
That's a good one. All right, Spoil. Well, I'll let you go.
Thank you, Demencia. Thank you. Thank you for being part of so many
God
years.
God bless you, Roy, and thank you for everything, and thank you for all the memories.
Thank you.
Thank you. Another thank guy, you know.
I remember his face quite well.
I know. He used to be in the front, okay? Bueno, ahora, señoras y señores, this is going to be Spanglish. Continuamos aquí con Rafael, ¿verdad que sí? Y Rafael hoy traigo una buena pregunta. ¿En qué me debo fijar al llegar a un lugar para evitar ser víctima de un tiroteo? Rápido.
Buenas tardes otra vez a todos.
Buenas tardes.
Gracias por la invitación nuevamente aquí a la emisora. La semana pasada hablamos de básicamente lo que tenemos que hacer durante el tiroteo. Y hoy quiero compartir algunas cositas que debemos fijarnos antes de cuando llegamos a un lugar, lo que es el awareness. Cosas pequeñas, cosas sencillas. Por ejemplo, cuando llegas a un lugar es bien importante identificar dónde está la seguridad ubicada, sea en un mall, sea en un evento, sea en un lugar privado, dónde están los guardias de seguridad, si están pendientes, para que cualquier cosa que suceda usted pueda rápidamente ubicarlos. También bien importante cuando usted llega a un lugar en el área de estacionamiento, usted parquea su vehículo de modo en reversa, porque en una emergencia es mucho más rápido salir el vehículo si está parqueado de espalda que está parqueado de frente. Bien importante esto que voy a decir ahora. Si es un sitio abierto, donde mucha gente transita, está cerrado por la policía, pero está abierto y usted camina por el medio de la calle, ha pasado en lugares donde carros han venido y han aplastado a personas, matado terroristas, usted manténgase en las aceras, en las esquinas de ese lugar, para que cualquier evento que suceda, lo más probable, ese tirador va a tirarle más probable a la gente que está caminando, no a la gente que va por las esquinas. Por eso usted se mantiene en las aceras de ese lugar. Otro lugar, si es un sitio cerrado, un evento, usted llegó y se va a sentar a escuchar algo, busque asientos en las esquinas del lugar. Cuando una persona va a hacer un tiroteo, y por los ejemplos que hemos visto, suele disparar primero a las personas que están en el medio del lugar. Usted busque las esquinas para que pueda ver las personas y para que tenga una mejor posición a la hora de un evento como ese. Y por último, fíjese en las puertas de emergencia del lugar. Las puertas de emergencia tienen algo peculiar, y es que usted las puede abrir por dentro, no importa el momento del día, y las puede abrir rápidamente. Usted las identifica porque puede ser el lugar donde usted puede salir en un evento de tiroteo.
Gracias, Rafael. Tenemos una llamadita. Welcome to the show. Bienvenido a Revoluciones por Minuto. Adelante.
Hello. Hola, Magda. Muy buenas tardes. Juan Saldarriaga, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, welcome. Dime, Juan, ¿cómo estás?
Hi, how are you? Well, first of all, I want to tell you, the gentleman, and thank you for helping the racing scene, and wish you the best luck in your future, and thank you for helping all these people through the years. They will never forget what you did for them.
Thank you very much. Congratulations, sir. Thank you.
Well, changing a little bit, cambiando un poquito esto, mañana, como sabemos, se lleva la gran final en Homestead, Homestead Speedway de la NASCAR. Hay una gran noticia, una grande noticia, pero antes de decirte la gran noticia, estos cuatro pilotos son los que van a estar peleando el campeonato por la Copa de la NASCAR. Martin Truex Jr., Brad Keselowski, Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick. Magda, ¿por quién vas tú?
Perdón.
¿Por quién vas tú? ¿Por cuál vas tú?
Kyle.
Luis, Lucho, ¿por quién va usted?
Kyle.
And Rice Spider.
Kyle. ¿Alguien
más? Who's your favorite?
¿Eh?
Who's my favorite?
My favorite?
Who's your favorite?
My favorite is whoever won the race. No, I like it to the years and so forth. I think Kyle Busch have a great opportunity. He's been there for a long time, and I think he deserves it this year.
Exactly.
Dale Earnhardt was my favorite.
Oh, okay.
Well, and you know, his son, tomorrow, by the way, tomorrow is the last race of Dale Earnhardt Jr. as a NASCAR race car driver.
That's
it will
wild.
Be the last one, and the team, the race car that he's going to be driving tomorrow, guess what it is? It's the same one when he start racing, the same car, the same paint job when he start racing in NASCAR a few years ago.
Oh,
bueno,
wow.
Pero la gran noticia, Magda, ¿tú sabes cuál es la gran noticia? The big news. Nada menos. No more, no less. Danica Patrick, no
Danica,
more.
Yes.
No va más.
Yeah, Danica Patrick, say goodbye. Yes.
She
say goodbye. We have to say this in English and in Spanish, remember.
Yeah, she said no more. She's going to be the last race. It's going to be tomorrow. But what she said, then she's going to be racing the Daytona 500 next year and the Indy 500, which will be the last race of her career.
Oh, wow. Well, let me tell you something.
A las 3 de la tarde se estará viendo la carrera en Homestead Speedway. La semana entrante vamos a estar dando un pequeño reporte de la carrera porque ahí el que gane es el que lleva el campeonato. No hay puntos, no hay nada. Uno de los cuatro queda campeón mañana.
Okay, Juan, pero let me tell you something, Juan. Juan, let me tell you something. Let's talk about Danica Patrick. Danica Patrick, what is this? She never win a race. Can you believe that?
Well,
never win.
Well,
right.
She never won a race, but what the reason why she moved into NASCAR is because she wanted to. NASCAR wanna bring the female touch, the female, because as you know, a lot of fans are female race car drivers, race car fans, and they love it to come over here. So they brought it in from Indy. She raced a few years in Indy, and she brought him in. And I think it was a good choice because she had a great opportunity, and a lot of females come with her. It was a great opportunity for NASCAR.
They need a female crasher.
No, it's bad, boy.
Well, don't tell him that to Mazda.
Right,
don't tell
no
Mazda
way.
That. We're out. Watch
no,
it.
But you know what? Anyway, I think this is the time to Danica say goodbye because she tried. She make hey, and I'm proud of her because it's a woman representation in NASCAR.
We ran
but
out
it's
of cars.
Time to go to say goodbye and
we
say
ran out of cars.
Goodbye, Daddy.
We ran out of cars. No more cars.
Well, but she was a good and she's a you know she raced hard and she never won a race in NASCAR, but she ran a lot of the top 10 races. But it was a good add to the NASCAR and a little bit different that they needed to change a little bit of as a Dale Earnhardt Jr. and Dale Earnhardt Sr. and all that stuff.
Thank you.
And remember, Jeff Gordon retired also last year. There is a lot of drivers and they are trying to get the new Kyle Larson, the one who drive for who took over for Juan Pablo Montoya. He did an outstanding job this year. So it's a new generation of drivers. So NASCAR is trying to bring the
thank
new
you very much,
blood
Juan.
Into it.
Yeah.
Thank
great.
You. Thank you. Have
great
a good day.
For the,
all right, guys. Anyway, so I'm going to have lunch right now. I don't know if my friend know, but Magda has a beautiful chicken legs. So we like to go and get some soup or chicken legs.
Oh, my God. You don't want to say that because I
all right, guys. Have a great
right?
weekend.
Oh, no. Don't go. Tell us what you're going to have for lunch.
Gracias, Juan.
Have a great weekend, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Let's take it. Vamos a tomar la próxima llamada. Adelante. Estás en el aire. Buenas tardes. Hello. Welcome to the show. Hello.
Hello, hello.
Sí, te estamos escuchando. Hello.
Sí, ¿me escucha?
Sí.
Es Nani.
La Nani Racing. Oh, my God. Welcome. It's a female in the house,
¿eh? That's what I'm saying.
Okay, Nani. Well, tell me, dime un poquito about esa guerra de las Starlet que se aproxima ya mismito. Ahí tiene la fotografía das de Nani. Hey.
Oh,
oh
hey.
My God.
Hey,
see that? De Nani, the shootout, okay. Nani, tell me, ¿cuántos van a participar en este Starlet shootout? El 1 del 1 al 3 de diciembre se presenta en Orlando Speedway.
Bueno, ahora mismo, si no me equivoco, hay una hey, que es la que están dando la promo, pero todas las que lleguen allí pueden participar del shootout.
Claro que sí, tenemos a Doña Silvia, tenemos por supuesto a la Nani. Oye, ¿cómo te sientes al tú representar y que hay una corona para las Starlet?
Bueno, yo me siento muy orgullosa después de poco tiempo que llevo envuelta en el deporte. Pues ya puedes ser un sponsor para lo que es esta categoría. La realidad es que la categoría se encendió cuando la Nani hizo su récord. Yo me siento muy orgullosa y hay dos coronas. Una, la color oro va a ser para la Starlet que gane el shootout. la más rápida del fin de semana. Y la plateada va a ser para la que sea más constante, la que corte sus mejores pases en sus números constantes.
Qué bueno, y recuerden que todo eso es auspiciado, las coronas es auspiciada por Peugeot Boutique. Cuéntanos un poquito, ¿dónde estás localizada?
¿O dónde se puede conseguir? Esta tienda es mi... en mi, pues en mi negocio, no tenemos tienda física, eso es por website.
Okay.
Lo puedes conseguir en www.spyot.com.
Okay, perfecto. Así es que si quieren una ropa bella y lucir, ¿verdad? Bien sexy, visita Peugeot Boutique, ¿verdad que sí?
Sí, claro, claro. A la orden para todo el mundo.
Claro que sí. Muchas gracias, Nani. Muchísimas gracias por sacar un tiempito, ¿verdad? Yo sé que estamos bien ocupaditas y you're a mommy y tiene mucho, pero siempre te acuerdas aquí de Revoluciones por Minuto, así que estoy muy agradecida y muy contenta de que hayas llamado aquí a Revoluciones por Minuto. Y
gracias a ustedes. Gracias a ustedes por el apoyo.
Ok, muchas gracias. Bueno, recuerden que doña Silvia, la Nani, la Yareli, la atrevida de la de Fondón también, la Star de Fondón, y la Jenny también va a decir presente en la Guerra de las Starles, ¿verdad? Yo le llamo. También Escudería Mectec, los días del 1 al 3 se presentan por allí, el Mectec Import Lab, el Humilde también dirá presente, y Rafaelito, el RX8, el Rafaelito, también se estarán presentando esos días del 1 al 3 de diciembre. Y por supuesto, tonight, Nine of Fire, what do you think, Roy, about the Nine of Fire, every year coming the Nine of Fire to Orlando Speedway? And today is another day.
It's a great place to host it. I know that.
Okay.
It's a beautiful show.
What are you saying about those jet trains?
Jet trained?
Yeah. And they have jet draster, jet funny cars, wheel standers, and much, much more. That's going to happen tonight at the Orange County Nationals 905. It's a mark already, you know, it's something that they show every year. Have you been in one of those 905 at the Orlando Speedway?
Yes, I've been to one. It's been 10 years ago, but probably one of the greatest shows I ever went to. When they fire those things up and you got that big old flame, it's like, whoa, I don't know where to run or stay here. Something went wrong.
Exactly.
But it's a beautiful show.
Right. Thank you very much. Okay, Roy, the Snowbirds is also December 1 and 3, and that's going to be where, Luis? The Snowbird? That's going to be at the Bradenton, and then the Citrus National and Palm Beach, also from the 24th through the 26th. And Crasherama is right there. Check it out.
Where's the Crasherama?
Crasherama. Be there!
Yeah, that is on the Orlando Speedway Oval track, right?
That's 24.
November 23 in Central Florida International Auto Show. So if you want to get and see what is your next car, ¿verdad? Then you have to visit Central Florida International Auto Show. Okay. So that's going to be in November 23rd. Starts at 12 p.m. and finish at 6 p.m. So I'll be there to see cuál es el próximo carro que me voy a montar. Or the next car that I'm going to buy. I know what you're going to buy.
What am I going to buy?
What are you going to buy?
Another Mercedes.
I think I'm going to...
No!
I want one of the BMW Z4s on
32s. Oh, I like those.
Put those on big wheels. That'll look good.
Okay, señoras y señores, vamos a ir a un corte comercial y comenzamos con Roy Spiker. We're going to start with Roy Spiker. And I'm going to ask him, what are you going to do if you are in front of the shooting place or something? Whoa. What are you going to do? So after the commercial, we'll be back with you.
I got an answer.
Don't go away.
Oye, gracias Puerto Rico por hacer de Street Legal Wet tu favorito. el que más brilla, el que más dura y el único que no salpica. Ahora te trae la bestia azul, el degreaser que pela la grasa. Más fuerte que la bestia azul, ninguno. No perfumen la grasa, sácala con la bestia azul. Street Legal te lanza un reto, ¿sí? A ti que estás escuchando y que nos estás viendo. No uses más de lo mismo, cambia la amarilla y la verde por la negra. Una vez que uses Street Legal multiuso, no volverás a esos multiusos viejos que son más de lo mismo. 100% hecho en Puerto Rico. Street Legal, multiuso, no mancha, limpia mejor y el que hace espuma para lavar tu carro. Búscala en tu establecimiento favorito. Atrévete a romper la rutina. Cambia a la negra de Street Legal. ¿Alguna duda? ¿No?
En Powder Coating Specialty utilizan una técnica de alta calidad para cubrir hierro, aluminio, cobre, acero inoxidable y cristal. Resistente al óxido y más duradero. Para que los aros de tu auto tengan este terminado especial y duren hasta 10 veces más que cuando son simplemente pintados, visita Powder Coating Special en el 839 South 2 Trail en Kissimmee, de lunes a sábado de 9 a 5. Powder Coating Specialty tiene mejor servicio, son más económicos y su trabajo está garantizado. Para precios competitivos, pregunta por Jimmy o Eric al 407-452-2423.
Al Pizza no solo tiene la más famosa y auténtica, sino que también preparan sabrosos sándwiches y calzones. También pueden hacer su orden por teléfono. Llame a Rubén al 407-935-0063. Localizado en el 1107 Bryan Street en Kissimmee, donde le darán el servicio que los han hecho famosos.
Berlin Race Club, 407-910-8226. Fabricación de autos de competencia, medio, tres cuartos y full chasis, roll bars, roll cage, cajita de wheelie bars, chapas para four links, mangas de diferencial forrado en aluminio y carbon fiber. 407-910-8226. Berlin Race Club.
Iturrino Photo Studio, sus fotógrafos profesionales para bodas, ocasiones especiales y todo tipo de actividad. Se producen portfolios de modelos y calendarios. Para precios competitivos, favor llamar al 407-694-2654. Contamos con artistas gráficos para diseñar tarjetas de presentación, flyers de actividades, promociones y mucho más. 407-694-2654. Iturrino.com.
Está escuchando Revoluciones por Minuto, este que te saluda Don Omar, Marta de Combi, sigue en sintonía.
Muy buenas tardes, querida fanaticada. Welcome, welcome to Radio RPM, and thank you to all the people that are in right here on Facebook, ¿verdad que sí? Gracias, tenemos mucha gente que tenemos por ahí, ¿verdad?
Por ahí está Abraham Torres, está Ricky Chassis, Alberto Santiago, gracias a todos por conectarse.
Gracias, gracias por estar por ahí. And, vamos a consentir tu mascota. La tenemos por ahí, Luis Felipe. La tenemos por ahí. Consiente a tu mascota. Porque, oye, esos son los que pagan este show. Si quieres consentir a tu mascota, llama a Ricardo Lai al 407-956-7466. ¿Ok? Ellos, Rainbow Grooming. Es Complete Mobile Grooming Service, okay? So, and that's my little doggy. It's right there, Leah. So you're gonna see my doggy right there. If they open the door, if Luis open the door. Ricardo Lai, recuerde, National, y está certificado, ¿ok? Así es que completo es un móvil grooming service para consentir tu mascota. And that's my little Leah. My little Leah. It's right there. It's a Jack Russell. Ok, so ahí le están dando su bañito. Así que, oye, llama a Ricardo Lai al 407-956-7466 para consentir tu mascota, para bañar tu mascota, para le limpian los dientes, le cortan las uñas. ¿Qué no le hacen a tu mascota? Concho. Oye, le hacen de todo. Así que lleva a tu mascota, Rafael. Okay, you have to bring your dog right there too. Okay, y luego, bueno, Gloria Hair Salon, localizada en el 9645 del East Colonial Drive. con teléfono 407-275-6494. Oye, ¿dónde están los profesionales del cabello? Y ahora con su nuevo procedimiento de oxigenoterapia y tienen tremendas profesionales allí que pueden darte el peinado que tú estás buscando. Gloria Hair Salon, también hacen, ellos también hacen peinados para weddings y bodas y los Sweet 16, ¿ok? Gloria Hair Salon, 407-275-6494. Bueno, y ahora quiero rapidito lo de Coto, se nos va Coto. La última pelea de Coto, señoras y señores, lo quiero decir rapidito y voy con Rafael y Roy Spiker. En el Madison Square Garden, ya escenario de la última pelea de nuestro amigo Miguel Coto. Y chequen lo que él tiene que decir. Ahí, Luis Felipe lo está poniendo. Ahí suena la campana una vez más para nuestro amigo. Para nuestro amigo Miguel Coto, así que dice, toda mi carrera ha sido increíble, todo lo negativo está en el pasado, ahora viene un nuevo Coto dedicado a su familia, pero antes que todo, no siente nostalgia de decir adiós. Y eso es muy bueno de Coto. Yo creo que sí, que esta última pelea, pero él lo arriesga todo. Luis Felipe, ¿verdad? Él arriesga todo en esta pelea y su última pelea. ¿Tú crees que fue posible que él haya hecho esto?
Una última pelea. Tú me das 5 millones de pesos y yo me meto en el ring con Coto. Yo me meto en el ring con Coto. Que me noqueé 8 veces.
With $5 million.
Pero por 5, ahí está, por un millón.
With $5 million, he go into the ring. What do you think? You do that too?
What, get in the ring with him?
Yeah.
With a gun, maybe. Or a stick.
Bueno, y eso fue nuestro amigo Coto. Bueno, señoras y señores, Roy les tiene algo que decir a toda la gente, a todos los racers. Roy, I know you have to, something to announce, and that's going to be probably in February next year. Tell them.
February of next year, because I think the property probably gone by March or April, somewhere in there, so it would be nice if we could put together a... I'll put something together with Magda and see what kind of response you got. If we can have a one big last blowout Puerto Rican party, Latin,
it's gonna be
whatever,
a party, señoras y señores, para decirle adiós a Leila.
And I think it'd be great. It's a kind of like a going away party. Be good for everybody to see everybody there one last time.
Así que si quieres ver a Roy, ¿verdad? Por última vez.
Roy, can we set something on fire?
Tremendo, yes, tremendo party. Yeah. Él quiere hacer algo, ¿verdad? Para todos los fanáticos, para todos los corredores. Un get together. Vamos a estar allí apoyando a Roy y diciéndole adiós a Lakeland. Y ese día, pues puedes vender, puedes traer tu booth. Así que nos puedes darle una llamadita. Puedes hacer de todo allí. Él va a coger el día. That's going to be around November. February.
Probably late February. The weather be nice.
You remember Pink's? Yeah?
Yes.
Let's say whoever loses will burn his car.
Yeah. That'll work.
Oye, y también puedes hacer tu burnout. Así que they can do burnouts and things like that, right?
Yeah, it's just a place to come and we'll have a great time and we'll announce it all. This just come up, so we'll put everything together like
es un,
we always
do. Es un party, un get together para estar junto a Roy. Así es que todos aquellos corredores, vamos, you're going to say the day next year? Around
next
January,
year,
right?
No, not in February. That? I mean, in February, the last
February,
part of February.
Year.
The weather breaks the first week of February, so anytime towards the last week of February, the weather would be great.
Okay, so para todos aquellos corredores, para todos aquellos fanáticos, vamos a decirle el último adiós a Lakeland y lo vamos a celebrar en grande con un party bien grande allí en Lakeland Drag Strip. Así es que reserva tu día. Ya pronto venimos con más información. Es completamente gratis y we're going to have booth, right? We're going to bring everybody.
We're going to let everybody. We're going to let them bring their food and set them up and have a party like we always party there in Lakeland.
Ok, así es que ya lo escucharon, eso va a ser en el próximo año, alrededor de febrero. Ok, tengo una preguntita para ti. ¿Qué es más efectivo para los ciudadanos, armados o no armados?
Bueno, más efectivo que los armados es mejor seguridad. Porque tú puedes tener muchas personas armadas allá afuera y a lo mejor no tienen ningún tipo de entrenamiento. Eso no garantiza que vas a salir victorioso en un evento de tiroteo. ¿Qué es mejor? Una mejor seguridad. Nosotros en nuestra compañía lo que nos hace distinto es eso. Tratamos de venderle al público, a todos nuestros clientes, una seguridad preparada y más allá de eso, entrenándolas cada mes. Inclusive hacemos lo que se llama el consulting, hacemos charlas, hacemos conferencias. Si algún cliente...
Rafael, ¿dónde te podemos encontrar?
Me pueden encontrar al 786-609-2285.
Para todas aquellas personas, ¿verdad? Para que necesiten seguridad.
Preguntas, aquí está. Consultorías, todo. Seguridad física, seguridad comercial, residencial, VIP, 786-609-2285.
Exactamente. Muchas gracias. Roy, what do you think if you are in the middle of a shooting? What do you do?
Well, if you don't have a gun, you would have to break and run and find your place to hunker down. Yeah. And when they come by, hit them with something, because it's better to be a dead hero than to be a dead standbyer. That's my theory.
Oh, my God. Y eso es lo que tú estás hablando, yes. ¿No? Él contestó correctly.
That's run, this hide, and fight.
This is what you have to do. Okay.
Run, hide, and fight. That sounds like a plan to me.
That's
not,
correct.
Not run, hide, and die.
And that's correct. And fight. It's very important.
So, si te encuentras en medio de un tiroteo, Paquito, ¿qué tú harías?
Yo.
Ajá.
Correr. Yo no voy a quedarme que me metan un tiro.
Ok.
Tú sabes. Y me preguntan, ¿por qué corres? Uh-huh. Y yo digo, porque no puedo volar.
Exactamente. Pero fíjate que yo me hago la pregunta también, porque en un pasado, in the past, I don't know how to answer that question, you know. But now I have a lot of, you know,
Magda,
information.
Magda, I've seen you with a gun.
Yes, sir.
You're dangerous with a gun.
I am. Yeah, but that was a situation where your life was right,
Magda,
there.
You remember the last thing you said when you had a gun in your hands?
Yes, sir.
You said, I'm going to shoot you in the head.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Because it was a situation.
She's dangerous.
I get involved, you know, and then, hey, his life is important.
Hey,
you
know? The guy told the cops, she said she was going to shoot me in the head.
Sí, pero lo que él no sabe es que vino un tipo y se metió en mi verja a pelear con él dentro y estaba drogado, estaba, tú sabes, estaba mal. Y entonces yo tenía otros amigos que querían caerle encima a él. ¿Y qué yo podía hacer? Pues sacar mi alma.
Perfecto.
Yo estaba en mi casa, yo no la quería usar, pero si yo la uso, la voy a usar muy bien.
You know what they were saying, excelente. The guys back there in the backyard? She's got a gun.
It's true. So, that's what you'll do.
I think as men, they would find their right position. Men would stand up and take possession of the situation. And when the guy got close enough to him, they could knock him out with something, hit him with something.
Yes.
They would take charge, because that's the way men are in this country.
That's the procedure.
I was thinking you pass out.
No.
Te desmaya. No, pass out.
You know when to stop?
You can pass out and pretend that you're dead.
You know when I run? When I run out of bullets.
Yes. When you run out of bullets, when you run. That's when you throw the gun and run.
These guys. Oh, my God. Okay, Roy, I leave you with the last word to the public, to all the racers.
All the racers.
To all the people.
I want you all to know that it's been a great career for me to stagger off into the drag racing world. I was not a drag racer at all, but I enjoyed the Puerto Rican people. I got to learn a lot about them and their culture and their ties and their families and how they are. And we're all the same. We're stuck in this big, beautiful world that we have called America. And I hope we get all of our differences straightened out in this country. And be truthful with you, I'm a Donald Trump supporter, 100%. Thank you very much, and I love all the people that supported me over the years. And matter of fact, I'm going to do, before I sell it, I'm doing the Trump rally. So if you're a Trump supporter, I want you there for that as well. If you're not, well, maybe we convert you over to a Trump supporter. We need all the love we can get, and we all need to hold hands and put all of our differences aside. That's more important than anything else that we do, that let the hatred go. And thank you very much for a beautiful life.
Okay, thank you, Roy.
You're
it
welcome.
It was a pleasure for me all these years. And, of course, we're going to continue being friends.
This forever.
Is on end here. Yeah. This is forever. But Para todos los fanáticos, tenemos un get together. Vamos a decirle adiós a Lakeland. Gracias a Roy, que nos va a dejar spend one more day in Lakeland. And we're going to celebrate, and we're going to have fun, and we're going to have food. So we're going to organize something really cool
we're
to gonna say
have
goodbye
some pincho,
to Lakeland.
We're
going right? to
have some pinchos on a stick.
Some pinchos y Puerto Rican food. Wow. ¿Verdad que sí? ¿Qué tú crees? Bueno. Así que todos dice por ahí, dice mucha gente que están por ahí, ¿verdad? Tú que estás en Shark, habla, di algo.
Gracias a todos los que se conectaron en el live de
del okay. programa. Ahora, muchísimas gracias a todos nuestros sponsors. Thanks to Al's Pizza for all these years.
Ruben, man, I haven't seen you in so long. Yeah. I don't know why you don't come see me. You don't love me no more.
You gotta see him.
Yeah, good. I got to come see Al. See Ruben one more time from Al's Pizza.
Yes.
And I want to say hi to my old friend Ruben there, a great supporter of the track. Beautiful okay. person.
Bueno, señoras y señores, ya no queda más tiempo para más. ¿Teléfono donde te pueden encontrar?
786-609-2285.
Okay, that was fast. Thank you, Paquito. Thank you, Roy. Okay, thank you, everybody. A todos mis sponsors, muchísimas gracias. Los quiero mucho y nos vemos en la pista.
Gracias. I like it.